You're ready for your third project. Here, I want you to compute fractals by solving the fixed points of the Lorenz equations. We did this type of problem in one dimension before, where we computed fractals from finding the cube roots of unity using Newton's method. Here, now I want to extend it to three dimensions and compute fractals using Newton's method to solve the Lorenz equations. So here's what it looks like. We're looking for the fixed points of the Lorenz equations. You already wrote some code to find fixed points numerically. These are the three equations given in this first line, sigma y minus x equals 0, x times r minus z minus y equals 0, and xy minus beta z equals 0. There's actually analytical solution to these equations. There are three fixed points, three solutions to this equation. The origin, 0, 0, 0, is one of the solutions. You can readily see that. The other two solutions have this form. One is the plus root, so square root of beta times r minus 1 for x, the same value for y, and r minus 1 for z. And the third solution is the negative root, negative square root of beta r minus 1 for x, the same for y, and r minus 1 for z. So there are three solutions. You can find these solutions using Newton's method. So we already wrote down the iteration you need to do that. It's the Jacobian matrix times this delta x, delta y, delta z equals the negative of f, g, and h on the right-hand side, and we do an iteration. So, like before, we might get a fractal if we see what initial values for x naught, y naught. So we start with x naught, y naught, and ask where does x naught, y naught, and z naught converge, right, using Newton's method. So to which root does the starting value x naught, y naught, and z naught converge? Okay, so we need some parameters here. We have r, sigma, and beta. So there are some classic values for these parameters. R is 28, sigma is 10, and beta is 8/3. These values come from Lorenz's original paper. He studied the numerical solution for these values. It was back in the 1960s, so computers were not so fast back then, but he chose to look at some particular value, and then following Lorenz, everybody uses the same value when they discuss this equation. Okay? We're going to map the xy plane, so we're going to have a graph where this will be x and this will be y. So these are starting values, x naught and y naught. Instead of xy, we're going to map xz because I found that the picture turns out to be more interesting if we map xz. And then we always choose the same initial value for y. Which initial value do we choose? I found that you get the nicest fractal if you choose a value midway between 0 and plus square root of beta times r minus 1. If you plug in these values here, you'll see that midway, it's 3 times square root of 2. So we'll fix the value of y naught. And then what I want you to do is to grid up the xz plane, choose the initial value of x and the initial value of z in this plane, iterate the Newton's method, and see which root gets converged, right? So then if you converge to 0, 0, 0, so if you converge to 0, 0, 0, then say you would color red. If you converge to the plus the second root, which would be plus beta r minus 1, etc., then you would color say green. And if you converge to minus square root of beta r minus 1, etc., then you would color blue. RGB scheme, color scheme, right? So you would have your grid points then would get colored red, green, or blue depending on which root you converge to, choosing x naught, z naught on the grid with y naught fixed. That's your project. So you need to do an iteration of this matrix equation and make sure that you converge for every starting value on the grid. Okay, there's a tricky point here, which I want to emphasize for you. Some of these values will take more iterations to converge than others. In the solution of Newton's method for the cube roots of unity, we were able to vectorize the code and do every single grid point at the same time. You'll find that it's very difficult to do that in this problem. So instead, you'll have a for loop, and you'll have to go over each grid point separately. So converge each grid point one by one. That slows down the code immensely. So if you did the same number of iterations for each grid point so that every initial value will converge, your code will actually run too slow. MATLAB grader will time out on you, so you can't do that. So now you're in a situation where you have to worry about the speed of your code. So what you need to do is to use a while loop. Okay, so let me put it in this box here. Use a while loop. Okay? What that means is that if you're in a position on this grid where the convergence is fast, very few iterations of Newton's method is necessary to converge, then you only need to run a few times. But if you're in a position on this grid where the convergence is slow, like in a fractal region, then you may have to iterate a much larger number of times. So you need to put your computational time at the grid points where convergence is slow, and then do very quick computations where the convergence is fast. You can do that with a while loop if you check for the errors as you iterate, so that as delta x, delta y, and delta z get smaller and smaller, eventually you can decide on a color and stop the iteration. You need to do this because time is of an essence in this problem. Good luck. I hope you enjoy this project. I'm Jeff Chasnov. I'll see you in the next video.